It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project situation, your site reliability engineering team does toil work to archive unused data in tables within your application's relational database. This toil is required to ensure that your application has a low latency service level indicator or SLI to meet your service level objective or SLO. Toil is preventing your team from focusing on a high priority engineering project that will improve the availability SLI of your application. You want to reduce repetitive tasks to avoid burnout, improve organizational efficiency, and follow the site reliability engineering recommended practices. What should you do? In this fairly straightforward question, we have a situation where a team is archiving unused data in tables regularly. And it is indicated to you that this is toil work that is being done. Why are they doing this? Because there is a service level indicator, low latency, which in turn drives the service level objective. Now, because we are spending this energy and time archiving these tables with unused data on a regular basis, time and effort is spent there, which should ideally have gone somewhere else, which is the engineering project to drive up the availability SLI. So we clearly want to fix this issue. The answer almost screams out of the question. Still, let's go through each of the options and figure out what would be the right way to reduce the repetitive tasks and also follow the site reliability engineering recommended practices. Before we go there, let's define what toil is. The book that you have to refer for this is the Site Reliability Engineering book, which is freely available from Google. That defines toil as the kind of work tied to running a production service that tends to be manual, repetitive, automatable, tactical, devoid of enduring value, and that scales linearly as the service grows. So when you say it's manual, obviously there are humans involved in it. And you know, that is usually a very costly resource to have humans do this task. Also, as humans, we cannot be there all the time. So ideally, this should be transferred to a system that can run 24/7. The work tends to be repetitive. We did something yesterday, we're doing the same thing today, and we are going to do the same thing tomorrow and into the future. It has to be automatable. When we talked about the repetitive work, if what we did yesterday and what we did today required some human intervention that cannot be automated, that cannot be done by a machine, then that does not qualify as toil. So this has to be something that can be programmed, that can be automated, but we just haven't done it yet. Toil also tends to be tactical as opposed to strategic. Strategic things about the long term, whereas tactical is more about getting things done right now. What would ideally be called firefighting. Unless we solve the issue right now, things are going to explode somewhere else. And it's very important, therefore, that we spend that time and effort right now, right here. But it burns away time and effort. And therefore, that's not a good thing. It's devoid of enduring value in that what we do today does not last us a long time. Let's say a machine goes down. It will again go down maybe sometime later, and we will have to spend that time again. So we are going to have to repeat whatever we did yesterday without it having value into the future. Also, toil scales linearly as the service grows. So let's assume that the service is growing linearly. Ideally, we want the amount of effort we spend on it to be sublinear. If the effort we spend is going to be linear or worse, going to be exponential compared to the service that is growing, that would not be a good option. We want the effort to reduce as the scale increases. With that understanding now, let's look at each of the options. Option A suggests that we identify repetitive tasks that contribute to toil and onboard additional team members for support. But hiring new people does not remove the toil. It only shifts the toil. The work is still going to be manual. Instead of probably you doing it, the new people are going to be doing it. It is still repetitive. What you are doing, they have to do. It is still devoid of enduring value because they will have to continue doing that into the future. And it definitely is not scaling sublinearly, because as and when more of this effort needs to be spent, we are going to have to hire more team members. So option A fails us on almost everything, and therefore we are definitely going to eliminate option A. Option C suggests that we change the SLO, or the service level objective, of the latency SLI to accommodate toil being done less often. So since we kind of plan for less toil, we can move that time and effort into the other high priority engineering project, which is the availability SLI engineering project. Is that going to be good at all? Definitely not. In general, changing the SLO to meet current limits should not be our first option. It does not mean that we should never change the SLO or reduce the SLO. Maybe there is a real reason to do that. But that should not be the first option we grab at. Ideally, those have been defined based on other needs, other requirements, and other properties of a system. And it should be our endeavor to meet those. And if under all circumstances it cannot be met, or with any of the approaches those cannot be met, then of course there is an option to change the SLO. But definitely should not be the easy option. Also, in this case, we are saying change the SLO because we're just going to plan for the toil being done less often. Can we do that? Do we have the luxury of making that decision? Absolutely not. The reason why we are incurring toil right now is because the system has to be kept up to meet the service level indicator called low latency. If we just plan to do less of it, even if we improve on the availability SLI, it is going to drop the low latency SLI. So it is going to make the system worse overall. And that's not acceptable. And just trying to wish away the problem that, hey, we're just going to have to do less of it in the future, or that we become more adept at it, at doing this manual work, is not useful at all. Therefore, option C is a definite no. Option D suggests that we assign the availability SLI engineering project to a different team, the software engineering team. So instead of us doing this as part of the DevOps team, now we're going to transfer it to some other team. But that's as good as hiring somebody else, right? Just reassigning the task does not mitigate the core problem. Now, they just have to deal with it. They will still have to deal with the fact that it's manual, repetitive, devoid of engineering value, and it scales linearly. But even otherwise, even if they were able to reduce it, it's probably something that we should do. Right? As a DevOps team right now, we have the development capability also. There's no reason to bring in a specialist software engineering team that has other tasks assigned to it. So ideally, this should be something that we should handle, and we definitely can handle, because we have the capability to fix this. So option D is out for me. Option B suggests that we identify the repetitive tasks that contribute to toil and automate them. Of course, this is very straightforward, and like I said, this answer was screaming at us from the question itself. What happens after we automate? We have reduced the manual work. There's not going to be people involved. The system can take care of it. Maybe running a cron job, running some timed job based on some other event. We no more have to deal with the repetitive work. Given that we're not spending time there, now we've got more time for strategic work. If we automate it, it has enduring value. What we do now can be repeated into the future without any human involvement. And it is going to scale sublinearly as the service grows. Even if you have a large number of systems, a lot of data that needs to be archived, then we can just run the script automatically at some time. Right? So this is going to be sublinear even if the service grows linearly. Given that, B is our best option. Now, one thing I want to say is, even though B was the right answer, and it was very clear to me when I took this test, that is directly B, when you're practicing for the test, and this is what you're going to experience even in your project, right? You might have this option that somebody says, hey, let's just automate it. But have we heard all the others also? Are there better ideas? We have to be able to evaluate them and say yes or no. We can't just jump at the first thing that comes to us. So like we work in projects, try to do the same thing when you're answering these questions. In this case, of course, B is our best option and stick with that. Now it's time to subscribe to all the great content we've got lined up for you to learn Google Cloud and to help you with the certifications.